Hello everyone, welcome back to my YouTube channel. Welcome back to another tutorial. It's me IJ and I'm back with a new tutorial. If today is your first time of seeing this channel, you're on the right channel. And my old and new subscribers, you guys are amazing. Thanks for your support. So guys, let's start today's tutorial. Today's tutorial is all about this trending blouse that you're seeing on the screen. It is an Isiagu blouse. You can use it to tie wrapper or to tie wear skirt. But the concentration of this video is how to achieve the off-shoulder trending exaggerated sleeve that you are seeing on the screen. So we are going to replicate this blouse. I want to show to you guys how you can achieve this blouse. You can use an off-shoulder pattern or a corset pattern to achieve this blouse, but mine, I'm going to use a corset pattern. I'm going to link the description box below on how to cut a corset pattern or an off-shoulder pattern. I've made all the videos on how you can achieve it very, very easy. So I'm going to link it on the description box below. So as you can see right behind, before me, I've already cut out my corset pattern that I'm going to use. This blouse we are making is being used with an Isiagu material. So I'm also going to use an Isiagu material to achieve this blouse. So I've cut out my panels. The concentration on this blouse is the sleeve. So I'm going to quickly put the body together for us to achieve the sleeve. The sleeve is what I want us to achieve, how to achieve this trending sleeve. So that is what we are going to concentrate on this tutorial. So now I'm cut out my materials and I've also lined them, put them the cup. I also put it warding, and also the blouses, I've lined them with facing to make it look rich. So I have to use facing to line them, and the body is a velvet. You know, velvet always is always elastic. So I now use face interfacing also to control the elasticity of the velvet. So now I'm going to fix them together for us to concentrate on the sleeve, which is the tutorial of today. Now I have fixed our blouse together. That is the pieces. Do you see it? I've joined them together, the front and the back. So the next thing now is to attach our sleeve, which is the tutorial of today. So now I've cut out my material for the sleeve. Remember, to achieve this sleeve, you must measure your biceps, and my bicep is 13 inches. Because it's exaggerated, you have to add some inches to your bicep. So my bicep is 13 inches and I added extra 5 inches. Let's see what I added. I added extra 6 inches, which is 19. So now I have 19 and the length is 15, which when I fold it and sew it, I'm going to have 14, which is 7 inches, which is enough for me. It depends on how exaggerated you want the sleeve to be. So I've cut it out, and also I now have to iron it with gum stay, the hard one, because it has to stand. So you have to iron it with gum stay or warding, but it has to be the hard one that will make it to stand. So I'm going to take it to the machine now to sew it. Take my half inch to close it up. Then I'll come for us to now fix it to our blouse. And also, as you can see, there are ruffles on the bust area of the gown that we are making. I've cut out my strap also. It depends on how wide you want it to be or how visible you want it to be. So I cut out also 6 inches and close it up. I have 3 inches. Do you see it? So now the next thing also to do is just to make the ruffles, just to take it to the machine and pleat it in this form to make our ruffle. Do you see it? Just to pleat it with the machine to make the ruffle, so that we're going to attach it there. So now I'll do this and I'll show it to you guys. Now guys, I have closed it up. Do you see it? So this is what we have after closing it. This is what we have. So to achieve the exaggerated off-shoulder sleeve, what you have to do is just to pleat it a bit. You can just pleat it on each of the sides. You pleat it and you hold it with your pin. But now it is a bit heavy because of the gum stay to make it stand. So you have to just pleat it. You can pleat once or twice. And on this side also, you give it a bit pleat. Do you see the pleats? So when you now attach it to your blouse, do you see the way it's going to be? Do you see it? So now remember, you are going to attach the normal sleeve, because without attaching the normal sleeve, when you attach only this, it's going to fall out of your shoulder, because it doesn't fit your shoulder. So you have to also attach the normal sleeve, which I have my normal sleeve here. That's my normal sleeve to attach to it, but the normal sleeve is going to be smaller so that it will not be seen. So I'm going to attach the normal sleeve here. Do you see it? And also attach it on this side. So this is the one that is going to hold my shoulder, while this is one that is going to be the exaggerated sleeve. So do you see it? This is the way it has to be. So do you see it, guys? So now I take my blouse. I now take my blouse to insert it. Do you see it? Just insert it in this form. Let's try to insert it. Guys, do you see it? Do you see the sleeve? And also the ruffle. I made also the ruffle. That's the ruffle that is on the bust area. You just attach your ruffle. Do you see it? Just attach it here. Let me also use the pin to hold it to show to you guys how it's going to look before taking it to the machine to sew it up. The ruffle is only on the front side. The ruffle also, you are going to also attach it with thread and needle, because now it's going to be difficult to sew with the domestic machine. After you might have attached your sleeve, that is when you will now attach the ruffles. So guys, do you see it? Yeah, so pin here. Guys, do you see our blouse? Do you see it? That's the blouse that you are seeing on the screen. Do you see how it is? So now I'm going to do it, attach it. I'm going to use thread and needle to attach it, after which I will now show to you guys the final look of our top. I want to show to you the easiest way to pleat this exaggerated sleeve. Now I have 7 inches as the length of my shoulder. That is where I'm going to attach it here. Is 7 inches, so I'm going to divide it in two. Just from here to here, I mark 2 inches, and from here I mark also 2 inches. That is 2 inches on this side, 2 inches on this side. So I'll now take it to the machine. just a little bit of folding. I to pleat it. Do you see it? I want to use the zigzag machine to hold it before attaching it with the thread and needles, so that it's going to be easy for me, because the volume is now much because of the wadding we added to make it stand. So now I'm using zigzag machine, you see, and on this side I also pleat it also a little bit. And while pleating it, make sure that the two sleeves are equal. Don't let one be bigger than the other because it's going to show. Let it be equal. So let it be equal. The two has to be equal. Do you see it? So now I've pleated it. Do you see the pleats? That's the pleat, guys. Do you see it? That's the pleat. So now the next thing to do is to take the normal sleeve, which is going to be on the shoulder to make it tight. I will place it here to also use zigzag to hold it, so that it's going to be easy when I'm fixing it on my blouse. So I'm going to also use zigzag machine to run it. Do you see it? Now I will also use the zigzag machine to hold the two sleeves together so that it will be easy. You see it? So that it will be easy attaching it to the sleeve when you're attaching it with your thread and needle. Do you see it? And on this side also, I'm going to take this to also attach to this side. And make sure that the normal sleeve that is going to make it to be tight on your shoulder is smaller than the exaggerated sleeve. Do you see it? Smaller, I mean, is on this side that is going to be on your shoulder. Do you see now the exaggerated sleeve is longer here than the one that is going to hold it tight on your shoulder, so that outside it is this exaggerated sleeve that will be shown and not the smaller one. So now look at the way it's going to be. Do you see it? So you now on like this, you hold it in this form to attach it to your blouse. Do you see it? It's going to be easier for you to attach than attaching it one by one. It's going to be difficult. So now I'm going to attach it to our blouse and I'll show it to you guys. Now guys, this is the end product of our blouse that we have just DIY, the exaggerated sleeve. After adding this sleeve, I put it on to see how it looks. It was nice, but the exaggerated sleeve was a bit much than I needed, so I had to trim off some inches, about 4 inches, then I fix it back. So after my bicep 13 inches, I added only 2 inches after taking off the 4 inches. Remember, at the initial stage we added 6 inches, but I saw that I don't need up to 6 inches to make it stand, so I added 2. So that was how I fixed it. So if you want that, you don't want it to stand in this form, you can maintain the 6 inches, but if you want it to stand exactly like what we are doing, you reduce it to 2 inches or maximum 3 to make it stand. And don't forget to add your gum stay. They add the hard gum stay to make it stand. Do you see it? So we have achieved our top. You see how beautiful it is. I'm going to now fix it to the mannequin, match it with the wrapper for us to see how it looks like. Guys, this is the finished look of our blouse with the matching wrapper. Do you see how beautiful it is? How lovely with the ruffles. Do you see the ruffles? We've just replicated what we saw on the screen. Do you see how it is? Just try one for yourself. And don't forget to follow me on Facebook, Iconic IJ, and on Instagram, IGA Designs, and on Pinterest also IGA Designs. I love you guys, and I'll continue to deliver what I have. If you have not subscribed, consider subscribing. Subscription is free. Share with your friends and family, and also support me by subscribing to my YouTube channel. I love you, and I'll continue to show you how I make my clothes. See you in my next video. Bye.